Chryso.
G'day.
Welcome to another LKS Ripping Tins reaction video.
Yeah, yeah. Today we've got a beer. It's
Weidmann.
Weidmann.
I think it's Weidmann.
Yeah, Weidmann. This Weidmann here is Roxxi Catalano from the great band Catalano.
Hello, Mother Truckers. I'm here with the boys today having a test of the young Weidmann.
Yeah, we have mentioned him once or twice on the channel.
He's got good taste in t-shirts.
He's a great man. He's going to react to this Weidmann with us.
So what is this Weidmann stuff? We've got imported, brewed in accordance with the German purity law.
Oh yeah. Is this legal?
It's got a picture of the fucking Weidmann on there.
The Weidmann.
Have a young gaze at them.
Fucking hell, imagine if he rocked up to your local.
Fucking hate your beat.
1.1 standard hoo has.
Oh yeah, that's not too bad for it. It's a little can, it's a little can.
1.1.
It's a small can, is it?
Well, it's 330 mil.
What I'm finding interesting is that it's best served at 6 to 8 degrees.
That sounds really warm.
6 to 8 degrees of separation. Let's get separated.
Let's see how we go.
Oh yep. Just as I thought, tastes exactly like every other German beer.
Yeah, who'd have thought?
Plastic.
Yep.
There's not much to it. It's a beer, it's nice.
Yeah.
It's fucking odd. Tastes like scones.
It's Weidmann.
Yeah, I'm not really okay with it, to be honest.
Well, there's three more, you gotta drink the rest of them.
Well, I will, but...
It comes with a duck catcher, though.
That's true.
How good's that?
Turtle choker.
How many beers do you see with a turtle choker these days? Fucking duck catcher.
But it has a handle so you can hold it sideways.
That's so you can catch a prey.
That's its best attribute.
So you can carry a prey home. It's not for cans.
No?
Scoop that up, get yourself a duck.
In there.
Take it down to the golden
circle. Take it on.
What else have we got there? Miss Maud? Miss Maud's on the side. Look, this beer's a bit of a fucking non-event, to be honest.
Yeah.
All these taste tests are going fucking very sour, aren't they?
Well, I guess that's the idea. We're trying to find some beers that we can react to. Well,
this is pretty cheap, but it's like 14 slugs for a fucking sitzer.
It was, that's very true.
Mm-hmm. So if you were to...
Cheap piss, man, yeah.
If you were taking the economics of it.
If you're in university, this beer's for you.
That's a very true fact.
Imported premium German beer. Not much else to say about it. There's a dog on the tin.
Mm.
There's a guy on the tuba.
She's got a sweet chick with some fat baps on it.
And she got huge cans.
Yeah.
And the cans are little. Ironic. This guy here is fucking dancing the Lederhausen strut.
Yeah. Dude with a tuba. A couple of young dogs.
Are you okay?
Yeah, a couple of young dogs.
It does.
How good is that?
Oh my god.
It does get bonus points for dogs and tubers.
I like your tits.
Tits rule, man.
They're all low though.
Screw the beer, let's just look at her tits.
They're really low.
Yeah, imagine the attitude she'd have on her, eh?
She's like a little front mount.
She looks like, look at the face on her. She's like cleanse.
I'm not sure if you can say that either.
Facial cleanse.
Like Darian Randall with a fistful of 90.
Well, just remember that this is brewed by the German purity law. So if you don't have your papers, you can't drink it.
Basically, I think that's the key point to take from this.
Yeah. What's with fucking Germans and purity?
Mate, their cars are pure. Their women definitely aren't pure because they take it up the dutta. Up the Kaiser Pass. German girls, if you're listening or watching, why do you like anal sex so much?
Leave it in the comments below.
This is turning into an episode, and it's a long episode about anal sex in German girls.
Oh, it's alright, we've got plenty of time.
And Germans love their leather, eh?
They like denim and leather.
And turtlenecks. Why do Germans always have turtlenecks? It's like a sensible, it's not quite a jumper and it's not quite the t-shirt.
It's like foreskin.
Germans love a good foreskin.
Turtlenecks like foreskin for their
head. Basically. Offers just the right amount of protection from the elements.
I got a 5-skin, man. It's like a fucking windsocker. Not a windy day, you know? Like
ruffle foreskin.
Oh, man. Holy shit. I can put at least 4 to 5 $2 coins in.
Had to put the cannonball under the mattress before he fucking knew what was going on.
Holy shit. I reckon I could, if I really tried, I could stretch me 4 over the top of this fucking
6-figure discount
German lager and play the drums on it. That's me 4 stretched over.
I felt the one I was down with a 6-figure discount. Coming in out of the sun like the hunt.
Fucking hell. Holy shit. You know what they call...
You know that Baron von Rickshaw, that fucking, you know, that...
You know what they... You know what they call foreskin in the gay district?
What's that?
Chewing gum.
On that note, I'm Doyle.
I'm OD.
Roxxi Catalano.
You're watching Rippin' Tins.
Like, subscribe, leave a comment below.
And thanks.
Don't buy this beer unless you're poor.